In this lecture, we start the active transport. Active transport. What is the active transport? Active transport is generally apun kay mhantoy ki they are required the energy in the form of the ATP. Mang in this active transport also against electrochemical gradient, and this is also known as the delta G is equal to positive. This active transport required the energy in the different form. Which form energy they have generally we know ATP, but another form is the light electron flow, PEP, phosphate, and electrochemical gradient. This is also known as the chemical gradients. In active transport, again, divided into the two types. So first one type is the primary active transport, and second one is the secondary active transport. This secondary active transport also known as the co-transporter. In primary active transport, energy is used in the form of the ATP or light. Basically, two form madhe energy kay keli jate, the use keli jate. In secondary active transport or co-transporter, also energy is electrochemical gradient and is also used to active transport of the molecules. So this is the diagram of primary active transport. Primary active transport mhanje kay jana, generally here is the chemical gradients. Kay asta chemical gradients asta ha jo molecules ahe to kay kela jato against concentration cha transport kela jato. So primary active transport are directly used energy in the form of the ATP. We already known in this primary active transport are also different type of the pumps include in. These also type of pumps are present in the plasma membrane as well as different type of the organelles membranes. Je cell chi plasma membrane ahe tyavarti ta present astat, but some are present in the different organelles just lysosome, Golgi complex, endoplasmic reticulum, yancha membrane varti pan he different type of the transporter presents astat. In primary active transport, he kay karta directly use of the energy in the form of the ATP or light. So first one type of pumps. So first one type P type of the pumps, and second V type of the pump, F type of the pumps, and ABC transport. So let's study in detail active transport. Active transport madhe firstly we discuss the P type of transport or P type of the transport or P type of the channels. So these transport also get phosphorylated during transportation. So these P type of the transport or different type of the channels presents. So in this P type, so pumps on plasma membrane. Active transport madhe, primary active transport madhe हे काय पी टाइप ट्रांसपोर्ट आहे. पी टाइप ट्रांसपोर्ट मध्ये काय येणार आहे, इन्क्लूड होणार आहे सोडियम पोटॅशियम चॅनल, कॅल्शियम पंप्स, एच प्लस पंप अँड एच प्लस सोडियम पंप्स. हे जर बघितले आपण जनरली सोडियम पोटॅशियम पंप्स ऑल्सो प्रेझेंट ऑन प्लाझ्मा मेम्ब्रेन. सो सेकंड वन इज कॅल्शियम पंप्स ऑल्सो प्रेझेंट इन स्मूथ एंडोप्लाझ्मिक रेटिक्युलम एज वेल एज प्लाझ्मा मेम्ब्रेन. सो एच प्लस पंप is present plasma membrane and bacteria, plasma membrane of bacteria and plants. So second last one is the H plus and potassium pump also present in the parietal cell for secretion of HCl, acidic nutrient, acidic material secretion sathi asto. So here is the one type of the diagram, and these pump P type pump also major electronic pumps in animals, and they also use 60% energy. So sodium pumps we already discussed, it is also inhibited by OA beans, and this is also one type of the drugs. Here is the example cardiac glycosidase, it is also digitoxin, and this form isolated for glue plants, and this is also inhibit of sodium pumps in different organism. Second one is the calcium pumps. This is also calcium pumps. Very easy, very simple examples. Calcium pumps present on sarcoplasmic reticulum, means smooth endoplasmic reticulum. These calcium pumps also present in the eukaryotic cell, in organelles, smooth endoplasmic reticulums, and these also calcium pump also synthesis of calcium. Sorry, intake inside of calcium in smooth endoplasmic reticulums. This is the calcium pump. This is the calcium, and these calcium pumps, they can present on the smooth endoplasmic reticulum. With the help of these pump, they can calcium transport to the outer side of the, means this is the lumen of smooth endoplasmic, sorry, this is the lumen of smooth endoplasmic reticulum, and these lumen are these pump present on membrane of that endoplasmic reticulum, and they transport calcium inside of the cells with the help of the calcium transporter, or sometimes they can take calcium inside of cell into the smooth endoplasmic reticulum, and their ratio of calcium transport is 10^5 × 10^7 per seconds, and they require the ATP in the form of the adenine. ATP means adenine triphosphate. One phosphate is required for the transport of calcium. So third one is the H plus pump. These H plus pump also already discussed. These pump also present in bacteria and only plants. These pumps also present in bacteria and plant. This is major electrogenic pumps. In H plus pump already discussed. Then fourth one pump is H plus and sodium. Sorry, potassium, H plus and K plus pump, electroneutral pump. And these also present in parietal cell and oxyntic cells. And these also H plus and K plus pump play also role in the acid secretion. Acid secretion मध्ये काय parietal cell काय करतात? Stomach मध्ये acid secretion चं काम करतात. There is the diagram of how to they secrete, how to they transport for molecules वगैरे in detail. This is not important for you. Second is V type of pump. Already we study the P type of the pumps. Here is the P types. Here is the type of pumps. This is also known as the primary active transport. We study the P type of pumps. In this P type of the pump is the sodium potassium. This pump also present in plasma membrane. Calcium pump also present in smooth endoplasmic reticulum and plasma membrane. H plus pump also present in plasma membrane of bacteria and plants. And sodium H plus and K plump also present in parietal cell of the stomach for the HCl secretion. This is also known as the summary of that pumps. We can also remain or understand this summary. We can also understand the all type of the pumps in the P type of the pumps. So second one also known as the V type of the pumps. And V type of the pumps also basically present in the different type of the organelles for the acidification or acidification. So V type of pumps also known as the, are present in the, identify in the vacuole membranes or tonoplast. And these also known as the proton pump, because these proton pump location in generally they have present in vacuoles, and they can V type pump also present pH 6 lysosome on the membrane of lysosome. This is the structure on the membrane of lysosome. These V type of the pump present, and they can maintain the pH of lysosome is 4.5. Endosomes 5 to 6 and peroxisome 5 to 5.5. These type of pumps also main function is the, this type of pump also main function is the making these organelles is acidification. Such organelles काय त्या organelles काय acidify करण्याचं काम काय करणार आहे? These pump करणार आहे. How to they can V type of pump play? Because V type of pump on present on the vacuole, lysosome, endoplasmic reticulum. These V type of pumps. So let's in diagram. This is the lysosome. on the membrane of lysosome, here is the V type of the pump present. And this V type of the pump also they H plus ion inside of the cell. And we already know, increase the H plus ion concentration in the cell, they can make a pH acidic. So this ion come through this transporter. So this V type of transporter also known as काय म्हणतो आपण त्याला जनरली किंवा रोल काय त्याचा ऍसिडिफिकेशन ऑफ सच ऑर्गेनिम्स सिंपली फॉर अंडरस्टँडिंग देन या टाइप ऑफ द पंप्स अँड दीज पंप्स ऑल्सो प्रेझेंट इन द फर्नांड्स पार्टिकल्स वी ऑलरेडी नोन फर्नांड पार्टिकल और F1 पार्टिकल इन विच ऑर्गेनिज प्रेझेंट सपोज दिस इज प्रेझेंट इन माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया मीन्स दिस F टाइप ऑफ पंप प्रेझेंट इन माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया अँड देन थायलोकॉइड मेम्ब्रेन ऑफ क्लोरोप्लास्ट अँड प्रेझेंट ऑफ बॅक्टेरिया दिस पंप्स ऑल्सो ओनली प्रेझेंट इन दीज ऑर्गेनिल्स F type of the pumps and these also useful in the ATP synthesis. Very simple of that function. Then last one is pumps, also known as the ABC pumps, and this is also known as a transport family. These ABC pumps or these ABC transporter are present in the bacteria, archibacteria, fungus, plants and animal, and these ABC transporter is the ancestral transporter because these ABC transporter are present in the very ancestral organism je junya organism ahet aple parents tyanche kay asel tyancha madhe ha ABC transporter present hota ani tya ABC transport pasun sagle transporter kay zale tayar zalele ahet ani mang kay ki ABC transporter also most involved in the active transporter and few are then also involved in the passive transporter. This is also last one transporter is the ABC transporter. Then some other another examples of transporter of ABC in bacteria madhe kay function in bacteria, they also take a nutrient and release a toxin. This is also function of the ABC transporter. This diagram show the inside of the toxin and with the help of the transporter they toxin release outside. And here is some another transporter, they also take nutrient. This also known as the bone function. Nantar in yeast, this transporter function also yeast release the mating factor. Here is the transporter present on this membrane and then can release the mating factor outside of the cell. This is one example. Then plants on the vacuoles membrane, they have present this type of transporter, and then function of that transporter is accumulated various secondary metabolites and xenobiotics, some toxic materials and secondary metabolites in plant cell they can intake or inside. This diagram show here is the DDT they take inside in vacuoles. So this is the function of that transport. And in animals some multi drug resistance protein they can release, suppose MDR protein, multi drug resistance protein they can release in toxols. It's an example. Then another one example is the light pumps, also present in bacteria. Which type of bacteria? Halobacterium. This present in light pump and they have present rhodopsin for 7 membrane proteins. These also working on light. So first one we study the active transport, primary active transport. Then second type we study the secondary active transport, and these also only work on or use the electrochemical gradient during the transport. Suppose here is the diagram. So this is the, let's show, this is very important for understanding the these concept, active antiports, import and another one. So this is the plasma membrane. Here is the one type of transporter This is the plasma membrane. Here is the transporter. Here is the one again one channels. Here is the transporter. So first we study the antiport. What is meaning of antiports? Anti means opposite direction. Means one molecule, suppose here is the three sodium molecules go outside of the cells, and second 2K inside of the potassium inside of the cell. This is also known as the antipodes. So let's draw here diagram. This is the cell. On this cell membrane have present one type of the transporter. So this transporter, suppose this is the sodium outside, goes outside the cell, and potassium enter inside of the cell. This is antiport, means one molecules are enter into the cell and second molecule is outside of the cells. म्हणजे काय आहे की सोडियम आत आला की पोटॅशियम काय होणार आहे, बाहेर जाणार. त्यातले त्यात सोडियमचे तीन मॉलिक्युल्स काय होणार आहे, बाहेर जाणार आहे, आणि पोटॅशियमचे दोन मॉलिक्युल काय होणार आहे, आतमध्ये येणार आहे. या प्रोसेसला आपण काय म्हणतो, अँटीपोर्ट. एक मॉलिक्युल आत येणार तर लगेच त्याच्या त्याच वेळी दुसरा मॉलिक्युल बाहेर जाणार. अँड दिस प्रोसेस अलॉंग रन्स अगेन्स्ट ग्रॅडियंट अँड दे रिक्वायर द एनर्जी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द एटीपी. So second one is the symport. Symports means both the molecules are transport in one direction. Both molecules are transport in the one direction. So this example is the sodium and glucose. Both are direction, one direction. So sodium can simultaneously transporter with the help of the transporter in inside, and that time glucose it transport inside. This is also known as the symport. Alag lakshat. Then second, antiport against gradient. Mhanje kay ahe ki sodium aahe baherchya side la khup sara aahe, tyacha gradient high concentration madhe aahe, tyacha apan kay lanu tela against gradient manto. सो समजलं का हे, अँटीपोर्ट, सिम्पोर्ट, मल्टीपोर्ट, यस ऑर नो कोणतं रिप्लाय द्या. यस ऑर नो, अँटीपोर्ट, सिम्पोर्ट. हॅलो, हॅलो डियर पार्टिसिपेंट.
Yes, sir.
समजलं का, ज्यावेळेस नोट्स मध्ये तुम्ही बघशाल तर तुम्हाला अजून ते काय होईल व्यवस्थित समजेल. सिम्पोर्ट, अँटीपोर्ट. ओके, सो हियर इज द डायग्राम ऑफ सिम्पोर्ट. सिम्पोर्ट मीन्स काय, सेम डायरेक्शन. सपोज ग्लुकोज असेल तर कुठे इंटेस्टिनल इपिथेलियल सेल मध्ये अपाइकल फेस मध्ये ग्लुकोज पण ट्रान्सपोर्ट होतं आणि सोडियम पण ट्रान्सपोर्ट होतं. त्याचं एक्झाम्पल काय आहे, इंटेस्टिनल अपाइकल फेस. मग ग्लुकोज मध्ये पण अनदर एक्झाम्पल आहे, सोडियम ग्लुकोज असा एक पंप आहे, सोडियम अमायनो ऍसिड पण आहे, सोडियम पेप्टाइड पण. दिस इज द वन ट्रान्सपोर्टर अँड आयोडीन इज द वन ट्रान्सपोर्टर फॉर वन डायरेक्शन. दिस ऑल्सो नोन एज द सिम्पोर्ट. देन अँटीपोर्ट अलॉंग ग्रॅडियंट, म्हणजे एक मॉलिक्युल आत येणार, एक बाहेर जाणार. दिस इज ऑल्सो नोन एज द अँटीपोर्ट. देअर एक्झाम्पल सोडियम अँड कॅल्शियम पण आहे, सोडियम पोटॅशियम पण आहे, अँड दिस ऑल्सो वर्क इन द कार्डिक सेल ऑफ हार्ट. नंतर देन अक्वापोरिन इज नॉट इम्पॉर्टंट. तुम्हाला अक्वापोरिन इज द काय, ऑल्सो ट्रान्सपोर्ट ऑफ वॉटर थ्रू मेम्ब्रेन विथ द हेल्प ऑफ द सम ट्रान्सपोर्टर. हे काय, डिफ्युजन व्हेरी निग्लिजिबल रेट आहे, दे कॅन नॉट फिलफुल द सेल रिक्वायरमेंट. मग दे कॅन रिक्वायर द वन channel. This is also known as the aquaporin, and aquaporin also useful for the transport of waters. So aquaporin madhe kay honar, simultaneously they can transport the H2O, NH3, O2 and CO2. they only transport these molecules. They cannot allow the sodium and H plus ion. They can only transport H2, NH3 and other. Then second one or last is the transport of macromolecules. This is also known as the phagocytosis, pinocytosis or endocytosis. This endocytosis again is divided into the two type. One, first one is the phagocytosis and second one is the pinocytosis. This endocytosis again is divided into the two type. First one is the non-specific and second one is the specific. So non-specific is they cannot require the any molecule of signaling molecule. They can easily uptake. So first one, non-specific is the phagocytosis. Phagocytosis means uptake of material inside of the inside of the cell. But which type of material? Just like a solid materials. Solid materials means bacteria, virus or infected material. They can engulf by the cell. This is also known as the phagocytosis. Or solid material. This is also known as a cell eating. Then pinocytosis. Pinocytosis means uptake of various soluble materials like liquid materials. Pinocytosis simply called as the cell drinking. They can take a liquid material inside of the cell. This is also known as the pinocytosis. But these also non-specific methods, or they cannot require the any transporter or any signaling molecule. Some specific molecule, some receptor specific means receptor mediated, they take ions or another molecules. So here is the phagocytosis. Phagocytosis means take a solid material, take a foods and some infection, some play the immune function in higher animals. In the phagocytic cells, different type of the phagocytic cells are the macrophage, neutrophic and dendritic cell also play the function of phagocytic cell or immune function. So pinocytosis means we already known as the cell drinking or take a soluble material inside of the cell or take a variety of nutrient. Here is the process of pinocytosis. Some molecules here, let's show the diagrammatic. So here is the some liquid portion that time required the cell. They can make some invagination and then they make a vesicle and they go to the target organ. This is also known as the pinocytosis. But this pinocytosis also known as the non-specific. This is the specific. Here is the membrane. They have present protein, actin protein, and mesh-like structure, and covalin. So that time they can require the molecule, some molecule they have. Receptor mediated. So in this only you understand the only AP2 type of the receptor here is the present. That type of AP receptor, some signaling molecule binding, that time cell membrane is invaginated and then again cladrine is removed by the with the help of the dynein. So worst for most important question, which molecule removed by the vesicles? For म्हणजे काय की प्लाझ्मा मेम्ब्रेन पासून ज्यावेळेस वेसिकल सेपरेट होते तर प्लाझ्मा मेम्ब्रेन मध्ये क्लॅड्रिन नावाचं प्रोटीन असतं, मेशलाइज स्ट्रक्चर असतं. मग डायनामाइन नावाचं प्रोटीन काय करतं की त्या वेसिकलला प्लाझ्मा मेम्ब्रेन पासून रिमूव्ह करतं, म्हणजे काय करतं ते क्लॅड्रिनला कट करतं आणि प्लाझ्मा मेम्ब्रेन पासून वेसिकल तयार होते आणि वेसिकल ती मग टार्गेट ऑर्गेनिल कडे जाते आणि आपलं प्रोसेस कम्प्लीट होते. मग त्यालाच म्हणतात काय म्हणतो आपण, रिसेप्टर मेडिएटेड एंडोसायटोसिस. मग यामध्ये फक्त लक्षात ठेवायचं मेन इम्पॉर्टंट आपला जो आहे तर कोणता आहे, AP2 इज द सिग्नलिंग मॉलिक्यूल. दीज ऑल्सो क्यूज द रिसेप्टर मेडिएटेड एंडोसायटोसिस. ओके, देन नेक्स्ट वन अपटेक ऑफ कोलेस्ट्रॉल, एक्वाबोरिन वगैरे. दिस इज द व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट बट तुमच्यासाठी एवढं सफिशियंट आहे. नंतर काय होतं, काही डिसीज पण होतात, ब्लड कोलेस्ट्रॉल डिसीज वगैरे होतात, ते इन डिटेल मध्ये तुम्ही काय करा फक्त वाचून घ्या. इट्स नॉट इम्पॉर्टंट फॉर यू, इट्स अ स्टडी ऑर इट्स युजफुल फॉर द नेट सेट एक्झामिनेशन. देन लास्ट वन कन्सेप्ट इज द ट्रान्ससायटोसिस. दिस इज द वन डेफिनेशन. ट्रान्ससायटोसिस म्हणजे काय, की एंडोसायटोसिस फॉर फ्रॉम वन फेस अँड एक्झोसायटोसिस फॉर from another phase. This is also known as the transcytosis. This also is pulling the secretion of material in immunoglobulins, and the immunoglobulins cross epithelial cell, and these also known as the passive immune feature. Ig antibody जे आहे त्याच्यामध्ये त्याचा रोल से. नंतर लेट्स हियर इज द सम डायग्राम यू कॅन शो आर अंडरस्टूड इन द युअर नोट्स. सो ओके, सो टुडेज लेक्चर ऑफ सेल बायोलॉजी इज एंडिंग एंड चॅप्टर नंबर 3 इज द एंडिंग. इन युअर गुगल क्लासरूम यू कॅन पुट दीज नोट्स. सो ओके, थँक्यू.